Hey, what's up guys, Jared here, and today we're going to be talking about how to get your application on the App Store. We're going to be using Xcode to do the entire project. We're going to do a little bit of Swift UI, but that's not the main focus here. The main focus is kind of the beginning process all the way to the end process where we actually submit it to App Store Connect. So we're going to go from beginning to end in that aspect. So let's get started. So first and foremost, we're going to actually have to create the Xcode project. So let's go ahead, create a new Xcode project, get started with that. Let's create a new app and let's just give it a name. Now when creating your project, you don't want to have spaces in the name, so you either use underscore or a hyphen or something along those lines because spaces don't play well with Terminal. So be sure to name it accordingly. So I'll just call this Hello World. With your team, this is connected to your developer account, organization identifier, and then next. Then once you're in here, as you can see, we have a very basic Hello World application. It really does nothing at the moment. And we're going to leave it as that, and we're going to see if we can upload it to the App Store. And so here's where you would do all your coding and all this kind of fun stuff, but we're skipping that part for today. But for now, go up here to your project, and we're going to select the deployment info here. So the first thing about the deployment info you'll see is like we have the display name. This is what's going to be displayed to the people. So if we can change that to whatever we want. So we can say it's Hello World, or you know, this one can have spaces. This one is just what's shown when people download the application. The bundle identifier here is important if you're working with Firebase or any other backend services. Then we have the version. Of course, you have to change this version for every upload. And so be sure to change that. Then as you build it, you can keep track of your different builds. And then we have the deployment info. And so when it comes to the deployment info, we have iOS 14.0. You can change the different iOS version. We're gonna keep it at 14.0. And then currently we have it supporting iPhone and iPad. And then you can select Mac if you want to. It's gonna say for Mac builds. As you can see, when you're enabling Mac support, it gives a little disclaimer here saying that basically you need to have your contents compatible with that of a Mac. And so you can either enable it or disable it accordingly. We're going to actually enable it. We'll see if we run into any issues with it. But let's see if we can get a Mac apps up to the App Store as well. Let's just make it match the iPad for now. Again, it's a Hello World application, so who does it matter? Main interface, we don't really have to worry about this unless you're using UIKit. Then for device orientation, let's make it so it only supports portrait. Then for the status bar style, you can either have it so it's like black on top, or you can have it as a light, whatever. We're gonna leave it as default. Then the big one that comes in right here is we need to have an app icon. So currently, as you can see inside of the assets here, if you go to your app icon, we're gonna need a ton of images. And so let's go ahead and create a quick little app icon and put this into our application. So we're gonna go ahead and create a new document here. It's gonna be a 1024 by 1024 document. That's the normal size for an app icon. And then we're gonna create a pretty dope looking app icon right here. You just kind of throw that on there and let's say Hello World. Let's take that, make the background, we can change that to what? Let's go back here, change the background to, sure, we can make it a blue color, a nice dark blue, let's make it black, why not? You're not here for design skills, so we'll leave it at that. And boom, it looks perfect. Okay, so let's go ahead, file, export that. Then in order to take that app icon and break it up into its various sizes, as you can see, it requires quite a bit here. We're gonna go to appicon.co. This is the best one that I found. It has an app for it, but we're not going to worry about that. I've never downloaded it. And we just kind of click and drag that image in there. We plug that in there. We generate it. And you can even generate it for Android if you want to. Then we're going to take these app icons. We're going to unzip them. And it actually creates an assets section for you. So we're going to go right into that. Take that app icon set and just plunk that right in there. Then we can delete this one. Take off the minus one just to have it a little bit cleaner. Then we go back over here and we're going to attach it. So again, make sure that the app icon source is app icon. And now if you were to build and run this, let's just build and run it inside of a simulator here. You should be able to see that we have an app icon on our application. And there you have it. So Hello World, let's hit Command Shift Home and you should be able to see, boom. There is our application and there is the app icon attached to it. And so now that we have our application basically repaired, let's go ahead and archive this and try submitting it to the App Store and see if we run into any more issues. So we're going to go up here and then you need to select a device that you have, or you can say any iOS device here. And then we're going to say product, archive, and then it's going to take a second, then it archives it. We're going to go ahead and distribute the application. Put it up to App Store Connect, Ad Hoc, Enterprise, or Development, and you can upload or export, and let's go ahead and click Next. And here you can worry about this stuff if you want to. Generally, they're already selected, so I just leave them selected. Then we're going to say automatically manage signing or manually manage signing. I usually select automatically because I think Xcode handles it well enough. And then it's going to summarize everything for you. You're going to go ahead and upload it. Here it says verify your bundle identifier, make sure that it's correct. So the issue with this is currently I don't have an application in App Store Connect that is willing to accept it. So let's go over here. Let's go to App Store Connect and log in. And once we are logged in here, we're going to go up to the apps. We're going to create a new application. We're going to select it for iOS, the name of this. We're going to go ahead and give it Hello World. Primary language, you can choose a bunch of different languages here. Let's go ahead and just select English. Then for the bundle identifier here, you should be able to actually see our archetap.helloworld. So that's already being handled from Xcode and being put directly up to App Store Connect. So you can see that all the changes are made. You create the bundle identifier there. And then for the SKU, this can be really whatever you want. It just has to be different than any other application that you have. It has to be unique. User access, let's go full access, create. As you can see, the name of the application has already been used. So we're going to say hello world slash archetap, give it a unique name and create. And so that's something to keep in mind. This name is what's going to be presented to users. So you want to make sure that you have a good name. And so now that we have an application up here on App Store Connect, should be able to go back. We say distribute the application, do all of those processes again, and we're uploading it. So as you can see, it recognized that, hey, there's an app already up on the App Store for it. Therefore, I should be okay. So now that we have that, you should be able to see up here, if we go to test flight, you should be able to see that we uploaded a new version and it is currently processing. So once it's done processing, this allows us the chance to actually post it to the App Store. So let's go back over here to the App Store and prepare it a little bit more. So when preparing to submit for the App Store, you want to make sure that we support the correct amount of devices and that you have the correct amount of screenshots to go along with those devices. So you see 6.5 inch, 5.5 inch, 12.9 inch, and 12.9 inch. These are basically the same there. And you need to be sure that your screen sizes, they look good. You want to make sure that they they draw people in and people can understand them. Some people even take them even further and put it into something like Pixelmator Pro where they can photo edit and add arrows and other things pointing to the direct features of the application. For our general purposes today, we're not going to go through all of that effort, but I will show you how we can get all of these different screenshots to upload. So let's go back over here to our application. Let's go to the iPhone 12 Pro simulator, build and run that, and let's check it out. But if you go right here into your iPhone 12 Pro, you hit Command S, it's going to save a screenshot. And here with this screenshot, you can take it, drag it, and we can plunk it right in there. Now it's going to say, hey, these aren't the correct dimensions. So I think we need to go for the iPhone 12 Pro Max. So hit Command S again. Let's take that, drag it over here, and it accepted it this time. Okay, so just keep that in mind. 6.5 inch display is the iPhone 12 Max. Okay, now for the 5.5 inch display, we're going to go over here to the iPhone 8 Plus, I believe. And then while it's building that, we might as well go for the iPhone or the iPad Pro and just build and run in the for that as well, as soon as this is done, I guess. So once we have that, hit Command S, drag it in, and perfect. Then last but not least, we have the iPad Pro, so go ahead, build and run for that, and take a screenshot. Now I do want to add that Apple now accepts videos as well. So if you want to upload a video to App Store Connect, you can just go over here to your iPhone. You want to build and run for your iPhone, of course, and take a recording from here. And so now you just send that screen recording essentially to App Store Connect. You do want to edit it up, add some fun music or something like that to lure people in a little bit more, but that's how you would do that. Now that it's built for the iPad Pro, go ahead, Command S, drag that over. And that should be good. Now I think this should apply for both this and this. Let me just make sure. And it looks like we are a go. Okay, next thing, you're going to add some promotional text. This is text that goes before the description. This can be specifically for that version, essentially. And then we have the description that's always going to be there. So this is just going to be Hello World or whatever. Keywords, these are really important for SEO. So if you want to actually be discovered on the App Store, you want to make sure that you have good keywords, that they're relevant to your application. And you also don't want to use too many. I know a lot of people like to fill them up, but you want to make sure that they're precise. They're precisely used for a purpose. And so you're going to say Hello, comma, World. comma application or whatever, you know, you can just keep going there. But make sure that each word is separated by a comma, or each phrase that you want to have as a search term. Support URL, this is your website. If people have issues, they're going to go over to this website basically. So you want to make sure that's relevant as well. If you have an app clip, you can upload this as well. We don't have one for an iMessage app. You can upload that one as well. We don't have one. For an Apple Watch application, you would, of course, upload any App Store icon through there. We don't have one either. Then we need to select the build. So that build has officially been processed, and now we can add this into this version. Does your app use encryption? This is generally applied when you're using something with payments or something like that. You can research this before you really get into it. But for us, we are not using encryption in any way, shape, or form, so we can go ahead and say no. Version 1.0, copyright, we're going to say ArcTap. Age rating, we're going to have to get this, so none. Now for the age rating, this is very important so that you are targeting the right audience, and so make sure that you are very honest here as well. So make sure it's, say it's made for kids or something like that, you're going to get your target demographic if you're honest here. Game center, we don't use game center. Sign in required, no. So we can go ahead and say this. But if you do have sign in that's required from the application, you want to make sure that you have the username and password and provide that to the person that's going to review your application. Contact information, this is how they're going to get back to you. So Jared Davidson, put your phone number here. That's actually my phone number, sure. Then we're going to go ahead and put that right in there. Then any notes for the reviewers, make sure that's in there as well. We don't have sign-in required. And then finally, for the version release, you can have this so it's automatic or manually release it. Depends on you. Then we're going to go ahead and save all this. And let's see, phone number, this field is invalid. Email couldn't be saved because another field is invalid. Okay, so I need to put in an actual phone number here. Future Jared, be sure to cut this part out. So now we can save it, and we can submit it for review. But no, apparently we need more information. So let's go ahead and see. You must enter a privacy policy URL in app privacy. So let's go over there. Privacy policy URL. No, we do not collect data. So go ahead, and here you can add your very own privacy policy URL. I'm more or less making up websites here, but if you're actually like uploading an application, make sure that you have a website and you have set up these various pages. Let's see, if we say submit for review, we also need to choose pricing. So for the price here, we're going to make it free. We're going to save it there, but you can also change it to different currencies. You can make it as high or low as you want, so on and so forth. You can even do pre-orders if you want to, but we don't really want that at the moment. Last but not least, we need to choose a category for our application. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's make it education, save it, and then you must set up content rights. And so if your application contains any third-party content, you're going to say whether it contains that or not. We do not. So let's go ahead and say save that and submit for review. And voila, we have submitted for review. Now, obviously, I'm going to cancel this and revoke it so that I don't waste the reviewer's times. But then I also forgot, if you want to make this a macOS application, you just basically provide all the information that we just did, include some more screenshots, promotional content, and also select build. So it's kind of exactly what we did here inside of the iOS application, just for macOS. Makes sense. But once you actually make your own application, hopefully this is a helpful process to kind of get you started and knowing what you need to do in order to get it up there. So thanks for watching, having a fantastic day, and I'll see you in the next one. Ciao.